Hello, my name is Pouyan, and I'm a product manager here at Tailscale. Today, we're going to talk about a feature that we recently launched called Network Flow Logging and Log Streaming. Now, what is Network Flow Logging? It is simply a log of activity that is happening across your tailnet. As a security administrator, chances are you would want to know this information in order to detect and mitigate threats, investigate security incidents, or simply make sure you're maintaining a good compliance posture. These logs include information such as which node is talking to which other node, how many packets are being transmitted, and what is the total number of bytes sent or received. All of these logs are associated with a timestamp and a node ID, which will help you build time series or correlate the logs back to the specific device that is transmitting them. As always, it is important to note that we do not log, nor do we have access to log, the content of the packets that are transmitted across your tailnet. Next, we're going to do a quick demo on how you can set up and access network flow logs. To set them up, go to your admin console, go to the logs tab, go to the network flow log subtab, and click start logging. And once you confirm this dialog, logs will flow. There are two ways that you can access these logs. You can either call this API, or you can stream these logs directly to a destination of your choice, which we'll talk about in a little bit. Now, in order to get these logs from our APIs, you need some pieces of information, which you can find for the most part over here. First off, you need your tailnet ID, which you can find from here. Then, you're going to need to generate some keys that allow you access to the APIs. I've already created mine, so we're good to go. And finally, you need to specify a time window over which you want to search logs. Now, in the interest of time, I've already have a setup configured over here, which I'm just going to copy over. So here's my tailnet ID. Here's a start time. And finally, here's an end time. And by the way, these times are in UTC. For security reasons, I'm not going to copy over my access token, but you can do so in a similar manner. Now, once I have all this information in place, I run this command and voila, logs are flowing. Now, as you can see, this data can get quite messy, and I don't think anybody finds the job of pulling an API to get results much fun, which is why we supported this notion of log streaming, which will allow you to send logs directly to a destination of your choice. As of this video, we support two destinations, Splunk and Logstash, which is part of ELK. In order to set them up, again, you need some information, which you can obtain from these partners. In the case of Splunk, you need a URL and a token. And in the case of Logstash, you're going to need a URL, a username, and a token. In the interest of security, I will set this up off screen, and I'll show you what the results look like in Logstash next. As promised, I configured my Logstash endpoint off screen with a URL, a username, and a token. Let's switch over to the server to see what it looks like. So over here, we have the log of this little ping I did a while ago. This is a demo environment, so we don't have much going on over here. But you have access to do all the things that you normally would in Logstash, such as searching over logs with certain keywords or selecting a custom time frame to zoom into. Network Flow Logs is available to all customers with a premium or enterprise plan. Log streaming is available on the enterprise plan only, and customers who are on that plan can use log streaming for configuration audit logs as well. Finally, I'd like to thank you for taking the time to watch this brief demo, and I hope you found it useful. If you have feedback for us or if you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to us via the links provided in the description below. Thank you, and have a good rest of your day.